Hi, my name is Charles. I'm the lead designer at Taito Robotics. We are manufacturing thrust measurement tools for propellers and motors that are used mainly on drones, as well as electric airplanes. Today, I'm going to answer a question we get very often is, why do you need to measure torque when you're doing motor or propeller testing? If we look only at the propeller, there's two variables that are important regarding the input to the propeller. The first one is the rotation speed, and the second one is torque. When you multiply rotation speed and torque together, you obtain mechanical power. So if we look at the propeller that I have here, we can see that there's only one coupling between the motor and the propeller. And the only information or the only data that is sent from the motor to your propeller is the RPM and the torque. What enters the motor is electricity here. So we can look at a motor as a machine that will transform electricity to RPM and torque, or electrical power to mechanical power. So when we have our torque measurement, we're able to obtain our mechanical power, and then we can divide the mechanical by the electrical power, which gives us our efficiency. Ultimately, this allows us to select the best motor for the propeller that we want, and we also select the best propeller for the type of flight that we're looking to do. Ultimately, it means that we have air vehicles that fly longer or that can carry more payload. Now I'll talk a little bit about how can we measure torque. There's many ways of doing it, but on our tools we use a steady state solid system, meaning that there's no moving parts. This is great because it reduces hysteresis and vibration. What you can see here is that we have three load cells, and each of those load cells is measuring two forces. So there's a total of six forces that are measured, and after a calibration procedure, we're able to measure the exact torque and thrust that is applied on the motor mounting plate by the motor. Now we also have to measure the RPM, or the rotation speed. This is done by using a small sensor. It's an infrared sensor, and it can sense when a piece of reflective tape that you can see here is passing in front of the sensor. And then the electronics is able to tell using a counter what the rotation speed is. So in conclusion, this is why you need to measure torque when testing a motor or propeller that's used on an aerial vehicle. Almost all of our thrust stands are measuring torque and thrust. So if you have any questions, you can visit our website. You can also leave a comment below in the comment section, and we'll be sure to reply to you. Thanks for watching.